Right. So let us take this problem. Now, what we need here is we would like to determine the resistance between A and B terminals. For which, so I'll take excluding the A and B terminals, I'll try to keep rest of the circuit into some box. Now, in this box, what is our ultimate aim is, so to make all these resistors into single equivalent resistance, only one resistor. You assume that in this box, lot of change is there. You want to exchange that entire change with some big rupee note. Let us say these are worth of 1000. So you need to exchange all these things and get 1000 rupees note. That is what our aim. So for which, what we need to do is that, so these things must be questioned every time. Is there any series or parallel connected branches? This question should come to your mind again and again when you are dealing with the equivalent resistance problems. And one should have the idea if it is in series, what we need to do. We will replace it with its value, which are some of those resistance values. If it is in parallel, what do? We replace those two by its equivalent value, which is R1 into R2 by R1 plus R2. So these two points should roam always in your mind. Okay. Now let us see here in this problem, what are the nodes? This is one node, second, third. This is, however, B node. So now, for this problem, try to observe, is there any series elements? If not, is there any parallel element? This you can assume N4, no issue, which is same as that of B. Here is same as that of A. Is there any series or is there any parallel? You cross verify later on also. So you can see here, within this box, neither series nor parallel is existing. So, what do? Then ultimately we need to make this into single equivalent resistance. But here no series or no parallel elements are found. So we need to look for now, is there any possibility of the star or delta configurations? Star or delta configurations. So for which, just you try to identify some elements as like this. This 10 ohms, this 20 ohms, this 5 ohms is straight away look like T network. T means star or Y. If you bring this hands, left side 10 ohm, right side 20 ohm, little bit higher side, just if you push little bit upside, that look like a Y or star. So these are connected in star configuration. Well and good. But what are its corresponding end nodes? As like in the previous conversion, I told you A, B, C, like that. Now, what are that important points? Is N1, N3, N4. Between these three nodes, with a common node of N2, there is a star network found. What do? We convert this star into delta. Thereby, we may get some advantage. We will realize that what kind of advantage we get here. So now let us see that what I will do is that, so first let me take one more copy of this diagram. First what we did is we identified the nodes and we cross verified is there any series or parallel. So we came to conclusion that none of the elements are connected either in series or in parallel. So, what we did in the next step, we try to identify is there any star or delta. If so, what are they? We identified some branches. Now, I will try to put some equivalent network between those nodes. What are they? N1, N3, N4. Between those nodes, some delta pattern network in this way. One is wherever I started, N1, then I reach to N3. From N3, let us put one more resistor to N4, and from N4, let us put one more resistor to N1, so that it has closed, one delta pattern has obtained with adding these red color resistors. What might be these resistors is, you can give any name whatever you want. Let us say RA, this has RB, this has RC. Now can you tell me, with the previous knowledge of star to delta conversion, what will be the RA? RA.
RB, RC.
RC plus RB.
That's what I am saying. Don't by heart any formula. Just simply see where RA is connected. RA is connected between N1 to N3. N1 to N3, in this path, what will be the corresponding resistors? You add up. That is what? 10 plus 20 plus 10 into 20 by whichever
five.
We have not used so far.
Five.
What is that?
5. Sir.
That's it. How much is this value? You calculate it. Similarly, what will be the RB? RB. So you start at B and reach to the N4, means in N3 to N4 in this way. Then in this path, what will be the resistors that you add up? So 20 plus 5 plus 20 into 5 by 10. That's it. Similarly, what about RC? What about RC?
5 plus 10.
5 plus 10, sir.
5 plus 10 plus 5 into 10 divided by 20. Can you give me all these values quickly? RA 30, this one is
70.
Huh? Is that 70?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What about this? RB 10, 15, 35. Very good. And what about this? 2.5 and 15. So 17.5?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we got these things. Now what we do in this step itself, so just let me take one more step just to have an idea that what we are doing here. These red color things are not yet coming to active as of now. So when it comes to active is that I should remove the old one. These old things which are in star must be removed in the next step. Now see that these values will come into picture. So what is RA? RA is 70, RB is 35. And RC is 17.5. So these are the resistors now which come into picture. What we did? Previously in this location between N1, N3, N4, there was a star. We tried to replace that star by this delta now. And try not to make use of both RA and 1025. RA, RB, RC and 1025. These 6 resistors together don't use it. Just here I am trying to say that you add in this way so that you will not have any mistake. Once you add it, then immediately you should remove this existing. And you should find its existing equivalent resistor values as RA, RB, RC as like this. Okay. So strictly speaking, here itself you should remove actually. As because I want to calculate these, I want to see these values, I am keeping them. In the next time onwards, I will do that, okay? Now tell me, is there any advantage of conversion? This is star into delta. See, previously when I was keeping these questions in my mind, I could not find anything. But now let us again replay these questions in your brain. See that, is there any parallel, series, etc.
parallel, sir.
Yes. So now, can I write the equation in this way directly? Total things as like this. What I'll say is that 30 is in parallel with 70. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
This yes, sir. Upper side segment. Next, 35 and 15 is also in parallel. 35 and 15 is in parallel. Now this 35 and 15 in parallel combination, 30-70 parallel combination, that means these two. Let me put this, some dotted line. This one and this one are connected in series. Combination. So, first let me write, those who can understand, first let us understand, then I will give you again the detailed simplification also if somebody is not able to follow. Now, these two dotted boxes which are connected in series got replaced with one value. How much is that value? Is within this curly bracket. That entire thing is in parallel with whom?
17.5.
Very good. Now, this entire thing, whatever I will get the resultant, that 17.5 in parallel with this combination is in series with
25.
Now you simplify in your calc. So, and tell me what is this answer. If somebody is not able to follow, just let me give the simplified diagrams one more step. This, yeah, sorry. So one more step here. Yes, right. So what I will do is that, can you give me 30 in parallel with 70? How much is the value? 30 in parallel with 70. Next, this one. Can you tell me how much is 30 in parallel with 70?
210, sir.
2?
21.
Remember, when two resistors are in parallel, the equivalent will be definitely lesser than the smallest resistance. In this 30 and 70 is there, parallel equivalent resistance will be definitely lesser than the smallest value, means less than 30. So 21. What about 35 and 15? These two can be replaced by one more equivalent resistance. How much 10. Is that?
0.5,
so 10. That
0.5.
Yeah, that also see less than 15. 10.5. Now 10.5 and 21 is in series. Could you observe that point?
Yes, sir, M3, simple node.
Simple node. So now that I can put as how much? 31.5 and 17.5 is in parallel. In the next step. Here. Now tell me, this parallel combination, how much is this value? Definitely less than 17.5.
11.25.
So here I'll put 11.25. Now tell me, 11.25 is in series with
25 ohm.
That's all. So ultimately we got the required thing, that is between A and B. The resistance is how much?
36.25 ohms.
This is what? RAB. RAB. So even if you do this calculation, you will get same thing. Okay? Right. So let us take one more problem quickly. The second problem. And see, again, you should once you see the equivalent circuit problem, you should think of this. You should think of this. Once you see this, so in your mind, these questions must be raised. Is there any series and parallel? If so, what are they? Quickly identify.
Yes, sir. 2, 2, 3, sir, in series.
2, 2, 3. This is in series, yes. This entire thing. Is
there 2, 5, 4, 5,
2. 2, 5.
4, 5, 2. Very
yes,
good.
Yes, sir, in
series. So, quickly, what we do? We try to replace those three branches by its equivalent.
Yes, sir.
Let us replace that. Try to work on these things. Now, what I will do is that I will try to remove this entire branch and this also entire branch. So, now I will replace these two by this side 2 plus 2 plus 3. How much?
7. Sir.
7. So, I will put that resistor over here. 7 ohms. Next, this side.
11, sir.
4, 2, 5.
7.
11. So, next, again, make that same question. Still, further, is there any series or parallel? No?
No, sir.
No. But we can find many star, many delta. Too many things are there. But don't like confuse with these many star or these many delta. You choose anyone very carefully. Very, very carefully. Anyone. So, in previous
six,
case,
six, five, six.
Yeah, 665 look like star, very clearly look like star, no confusion at all, right? So, but we already converted star to delta in the previous example. I will try to take to get make you aware of the delta to star conversion also. So, I will choose some delta. So, which one we can choose is many things. One is 3, 6. 6 is in delta.
6, 5, 11.
Or you can choose
6, 5, 11.
6, 5, 11. Or you can choose 2, not, this won't come. This won't come, right? This won't come. Only that's all. Yeah,
yes, sir.
That's all. Only two deltas are there. You choose any one. So, then, let me choose in this way. So, this is little straightforward. So, I'll take this one. And where these corresponding nodes, let us indicate. This is one node. This is second. This is, this entire thing is second. This is the third. So, now let me name that as N1, N2 and here B is already there, B. Now, between N1, N2, B, I would like to put one star configuration for which what you do is that inside the delta there will be some gap usually. At some place at the center you try to put one dot. Whenever delta to star conversion is taking place, a new extra node will be generated. That is what the common terminal N. From that terminal to the identified nodes, you try to add some resistors. One node is N1, other node is B, one more node is N2. Now you can name anything, no issue. This is R1. This is R2, this is R3. Now tell me what will be the new corresponding values R1. So for R1, just you go and sit on R1 to your left side and right side. What are the resistors? 6 into 11 divided by 6 plus 11 plus 5. This I will consider as some delta. Every time I won't repeat, this is how much? So 22. So divided by delta. What about R2? This is R2. So towards left side is this, towards right side is this. So how much is that? 5 into 11 divided by delta. What about R3? Carefully see. Towards left side 5, towards right side 6. So 5 into 6 divided by delta. What are these values? Can you tell me? 6 into 11 divided by 22. So is it 3?
3.
What about this? 11 by 22, 2.
2.5. 5 by 2.
2.5. What about this?
30 by 22.
30 by 22. Okay. So now what we do? We got the new values. What are they? R1, R2, R3. What shall I do? We should remove the old delta connected resistors. Straight away we can remove it. In this way, try to carefully observe. So better to use in the exam with pencil, draw these diagrams so that you can make these equivalent circuit exam questions very easily. You no need to take 2 to 3 times of drawings. Now try to see carefully. Is there any advantage of this conversion? Yes? R1
yes, sir.
Is 3 ohms and R2 is 2.5. Then R3 is
1.36.
Now see, N2 has become simple node. So 3 and 3 are in series. Let me take one more step. Let me retain that diagram for your understanding. So now try to see that. So on the above diagram itself, I will try to draw something in this way. 3 and 3 are in series. Next is 6. 1.36 also in series.
2.57 after that
these two are in parallel. After that, that entire thing is in series with 2 and 2.5. so clear? Now let us replace these things carefully. 3 and 3 will become 6. So let me join that 6 over here. This becomes 6. Next, 6 and 1.36 becomes 7.36. So this becomes 7.36. Now 6 and 7.36 is in parallel. See that these two are in parallel. What do we do? Let me take this diagram again. One more step. Tell me what how much is this value?
0.3, sir.
I can write here 6 into 7.36 divided by 6 plus
7.36.
3.3, sir. 3.3. So now I can remove this entire resistance, two combinations by, and I can replace with one resistance, 3.3. Now 3.3 and 2 and 2.5, these three, how they are connected? In the next step, how these are connected?
Series.
How much is this value?
7.8.
Then 7.8, that and 7 is in parallel. So this entire thing, blue color one, is 2 plus 3.3 plus 2.5. How much is this? 7.7, is it? 7.8 and 7 are in parallel. Ultimately, RAB is equal to, how much is this value? So, 7 into 7.8 divided by 7 plus
3.6 ohms.
So, I can make one more step ahead that now this entire thing is the resistance between A and B. How much is that? 3.6 ohms. So, in this way we can use the conversion of star to delta or delta to star also. Let us take one more problem. Very interesting. This is what the Wheaton bridge kind of thing. So, here the bridge branches are these edge branches. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. So, we will have galvanometer between these bridge edges, that is between N2 and N3. Its resistance might be 6 ohms, this one. So, this might be connected with the source, with source internal resistance of 1 ohm. So, this is what the source. So, this is the generalized way. Usually, bridges have 4 branches. So, in between this is what the galvanometer resistance. So, it doesn't matter what is the application of this circuit. Just we have this circuit and let us see what is the question. Question is, how much is the current I? So, as of now we don't know any other technique. What we know is that only Ohm's law and Kirchhoff voltage loss or current loss. Can I write V is equal to I into R? If I know this entire equivalent resistance as Req, as Req, can I write I is equal to V by Req? So, for which what we need to do? We would like to replace all these resistors by a single equivalent resistor. Then for which we should have a common question in our mind that is there any series or parallel connected branches in this given circuit? So,
no, sir.
If not, then is there any star or delta? If so, what are they? Then let us choose something. So, any some branches. Can I choose, so this star 1 ohm, 10 ohm and 12 ohms. And can I convert this into delta? There might be some advantage, let us see. Got my point? Which resistors I am choosing?
1 ohm, 10 ohm, 12 ohm.
Yeah, right. First, let us mark those branches little bit different way. These are the branches which I am choosing. For which, what are the corresponding nodes, end nodes? These. A, N2, N3. Now, let us start it somewhere. A, or just to have a better understanding. So, let me take a separate diagram for this. Later on I won't take in this way separate diagram. So, but just to make you understand in a better way, I'm taking this diagram. Only these branches which I selected, I had chosen. This is what N2, this is what N3, this is what A. So, this is 1 ohm, 10 ohms, and 12 ohms. Now let us try to make, here there is a common node, no issue, whatever may be the name of the node. So now let us see what are the nodes we identified actually. Is A, N2, N3. Between these three nodes, this star connected network need to replace with delta. So let us start at any one node. Forget this common node. No issue. So now let us choose at A terminal. Start at A to next node, you add one resistor. And from there to next node, you add one more resistor. And from there to next node, you add one more resistor. This red color one look like the delta. You can give any name, no issue. Some RA, RB, R1, R2, whatever it may be. Now let us try to find what will be these values. To find these values, I will try to see to reach A to B, I choose in this path. So beside my right side, what are the resistors coming across to me when I was traveling? 1, 9, 12. Similarly, when I am traveling from N3 to N2, this is my journey. So beside right side, what are the resistors coming to me? 12 and 10. In the same way, when I am traveling from N2 to A, to right side, what are the elements? 10 and 1. So now let us quickly make these resistor values. RA is equal to 1 plus 12 plus 1 into 12 by left out one, 10. Out of 3 elements, 2 we are using, but 1 we got left, we left it. So let us find that. How much is this? Next, RB, 10 plus 12 plus 10 into 12 by 1. What about RC? 1 plus 10 plus 1 into 10 by 12. How much all these values?
142.2
142.2
142.2 142, sir. That much? Yes, sir. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Sir,
14.3,
sir.
142. This is 14.3. I need exact answer. No, it is 12. See, 12 by 14.2. 1.2. So then 13, 14.2 only. This is 142.
Yes, sir.
What about this?
11.8, sir.
11.8. Very good. So we got these three. Now what do we do? We replace the elements which are in black color by these red color elements in the original network. This is what the conversion is. So just let me keep this circuit same. And let me take one more copy of this and I'll do that replacement over here. So here, so what I'll do is that just I have so this similarity calculation. So I will try to remove here initially, then I will add those resistors. This is the general method, but you can make on the same circuit by taking one copy here, and as like in the previous example, you can remove, no issue. Now from A to N3, how much is the resistance?
11.8.
A to N3. This 14.2. RA, right? A to N3 is RA. Next, N3 to RB, we need to remove this 6. No, 6 is there. 6 is not part of our calculation. Only these 3 we need to remove, right? Only these three are yes, participating sir. In our calculation. We need to remove only those three, not six. So, next N3 to N2, how much is the resistance? RB.
142.
Very good. 142. Fine. Next, between N2 to A, how much is the resistance?
11.8.
RC, which is 11.8. Now see, is there any series or parallel?
Parallel.
142, 6.
Yeah, exactly. In parallel, sir. So, 142 and 6 are in parallel. Very good. These are in parallel. Let us replace quickly in the next step. How much is its value?
5.7.
5.7. So, I'll replace these two by single resistance, How much is that value? Is 5.7, is that?
Yes, sir.
5.7 ohms. Now again make that same question. Is there any series parallel elements here?
11.
Which one? 11.8? Complete, madam. You said 11.8 and something. Tell me. 11.8 and something.
No, sir. Sarga chole.
Okay, then fine. So, now again, we came to a situation, none of the elements are either in series or in parallel. So, what do we do? Means, in the previous conversion, we got small advantage. We are unlucky people. Only two elements got parallel. No other things. What do we do? Again, you identify some other group of resistors, either in star or delta, choose some three resistors and convert to other form. Which one we choose it? Now let me choose this.
8.5.7, sir.
Previously I converted. So which one? Star into delta. Now let me choose delta into star so that you will get awareness on all type of conversion. But no limitation that you should choose only these branches. You can choose other branches also. No issue. Means like this. 14.2, 5.7 and 5 are in star. We can convert that into delta. One case. Second case is 11.8, 5.7, 8 is also star. You can choose either this one or other one. Or you can choose this 5.785 delta into star, or 11.8, 14.2, 5.7. This also delta, you can convert this into star. So you'll get some advantage. So whichever you want, you can choose it. No issue. So what I will do is that I'll take 5.785, this delta into, I'll try to convert into star, for which I am trying to take at the middle some node. So here to know that middle node to three nodes, I'll try to add three resistors. Now once we get these values, I will try to remove the old highlighted resistors. Now tell me some numbering. Let me give this as R1. I hope it is visible. R2, R3. Now quickly tell me what is R1?
5.7 into 5 by
5 into 5.7 divided by delta. I'll write a delta here. Delta is
5.7
plus 5 plus 8.
5 plus 8. Very good. How much is this value? You calculate quickly. R2 is 8 into 5 divided by delta. R3 is, and 8 into 5.7 divided by delta. So tell me these values. How much is delta? So 13 plus 5.
1.5, sir. R1
is 1.5. Okay. R2?
2.1.
2.1. R3?
2.4.
Delta?
18.7.
Okay. So now let us remove the delta connected resistors here itself. Why? Because its equivalent resistors I already found it. Now observe, is there any series or parallel? No, it is much easier. R1 and 14.2.
Series.
Next. Series, sir.
R2 and 11.8.
Series.
Next.
Both are parallel.
Both are in parallel. Very good.
And that is series with R3, sir.
Yeah.
R2.
So, first tell me what are these two equivalent. So then we move step by step here to here. How much is this value? This one is R1. R1 value is 1.5 and 14.2. How much is this?
15.7.
Next, 11.8 and R3. R3 is 2.4. 2.4 plus 11.8. How much is this? How much is this resistance value? This is R2.
14.2
ohms. Then R2 is known already, 2.1. Okay. So now tell me, these two are in parallel and that is in series with this. So finally tell me, how much is the equivalent resistance? Req is, so I can write in this way, 14.2 inverse plus 15.7 inverse. Try to habituate this. I told you in the previous session.
Whole inverse.
Plus 2.1. That is what equivalent resistance.
2.1.
How much is this?
2.23, sir.
Okay. 2.23 ohms. Now, finally, what we do is that here we have a voltage source. Now we made that entire box into single equivalent resistance whose value is 2.23. Now the current is I and here 10 volt source is there. What do we need is this current I. I is equal to 10 divided by 2.23. How much is this current?
4.4
amperes. So in this way, we can find the current also. Many people will complete up to R equivalent.
4.48, sir.
4.48, okay. No issue. So this is the way of calculating the equivalent resistance. Once we get the equivalent resistance, you can utilize that equivalent resistance to calculate the current. Okay. Thank you.